So is racism the new N-word?
This is a world. This is a world premiere. This is a world.
Hey y'all, welcome back to another Food for Thought. So I'm gonna get y'all caught up a little bit on what's been going on here at Altspace in Detroit and some things that are brewing back in Brooklyn, as well as taking on this topic that is the title of this particular video. Also, you know, I'm in rehearsal for Hamlet with a company called Shakespeare in Detroit, and I'm gonna be performing that in New Center Park here in Detroit. I'll include some information in the description box below. Also, I'm really excited the Project Ready, Set, Go race is likely to be mounted again in the fall. We're actually having conversations with a few venues who might even be interested in co-producing the piece. Hopefully the original cast will be coming back. Look for information on that in weeks to come. So this racism thing, y'all, I'm like not exactly sure how to even start this conversation.
Rich Piana said the dreaded N-word. For those of you who don't know what happened, a phone call between Rich Piana and his ex-girlfriend got leaked. And apparently, Rich's ex-girlfriend cheated on him with a black guy, and this black guy happened to be Magic Johnson. And Rich Piana just totally lost his shit.
Are you a fucking nigger lover? Are you a motherfucking piece of shit? White trash? Fucking nigger lover?
Yeah, Rich, I guess I'm a nigger lover. Yeah, Rich. What? I guess I'm a nigger lover.
So you get the point, but interestingly enough, Vegan Gains goes on in his video to basically apologize for Rich Piana for using the N-word over and over again. And I have to say that I don't necessarily blame Richard for thinking it's a big deal that people are getting all blown out of shape for this video that came out 10 years ago about Rich Piana using the N-word. What's funny to me is that more people seem to be offended about Rich Piana being called a racist for using the N-word. And this is where this video may kinda go off the rails. So I recently made a video saying it was the last video that I was gonna be making on the N-word, and this video is not at all about the N-word. So Rich Piana 10 years ago or 20 years ago used the N-word. Does it mean he's a racist? I don't know, probably. But the fact of the matter is that those of us who are living in the Americas, that's Canada, that's South America, that's the United States, are all living in a colonized society that was founded on the belief that the people who were here were less important, less human, less valid than the people who came in. And a lot of that validation was justified through racism. So the fact that many of us are even here is a testament to the fact that we accept that those who came took this land from those who were here before. We accept the fact that people were enslaved and became the labor force that built up the United States. We accept all of those things. So on some level, we're racist. Just as on some level, even the most staunch vegan accepts the fact that other human beings do horrible things to animals. My issue is with how upset people seem to get over being categorized as racist. So here's my thinking. In the same way that people may need to get over the N-word, the word nigger, people may need to get over the word racist. I've said this a million times. Has anybody ever gone to jail simply for being a racist? So my question is, what is so upsetting to people about being called a racist? It seems to me that people are more concerned with being called a racist than actually being racist. I mean, look at Corey and Tara McCarthy, who make the most blatant, blanket, racist statements imaginable, yet we'll follow those statements up with saying, but we're not racist. As if somehow it's that word that makes the thinking bad, or it's that word being applied to the action that makes it bad, not the action or the language itself. And of course, I do want to talk a little bit about Vegan Gains, who so quickly rushes to Rich Piana's defense. Like, really, what's that about? Kat Blaque actually made a video recently talking about feminist taking the red pill, how it's become very popular for people who were feminist, it's actually happening with a lot of vegans, to kind of turn the tables and become anti the thing that they had been. I think it's because people are realizing that the money is in reinforcing the status quo thinking. So as a YouTuber, if I'm depending on my content and views to, say, pay my rent or feed myself, it's going to be in my best interest to make the videos that are going to be the most popular, that are going to make the most money. There seems to be a tradition on YouTube of content creators who are African American, content creators who are women, content creators who used to be vegan, coming out and speaking against the group that they might more readily identify with. Kat Blaque talks about it beautifully in her video, so I won't go on about it. I will just link to Kat Blaque's video in the description box below, or maybe someplace up here. So what do you think? Is this offense that people get at being referred to as racist blown out of proportion? Or have you observed, as I have, that being racist is kind of becoming popular again? I don't know, what do you think? That's it for this video. Like it if you like it, share, comment, subscribe. This is Reg signing off. Love yourselves. Peace. And I love myself.